Hello there. I'm currently at a roadside rest area driving the Stuart Highway. That way north is Alice Springs. That way south is Earl Dunda, where I'll make the turn off to the highway which goes to Ayers Rock. It's a little bit uncomfortable. As you can see, I'm, you know, Australia. They drive on the left here. Pedals work the same way. Fortunately, I do have an automatic tendency with manual transmission when the steering column's on the other side is you want to mirror all of your actions. So you want to do things like first up and towards you and then second down. But the thing is the gears don't change. So you would try to shift the car into, you know, fifth gear or reverse. And so a lot of times, for instance, the first time I was in Cyprus, I was traveling with a friend and he did most of the driving, but he would do that all the time. And I even tried to drive the manual on with the steering column on this side once, and I did the same thing. Because you want to mirror all of your actions, even though everything is the same. So it's not too weird driving on the left. Of course, I did it when I rented a car back to go to the Blue Mountains back in March, and then I've driven on the left in Cyprus. The problem mainly isn't necessarily driving on the left, rather where the steering column is, because you want to position yourself to the right of center with respect to the middle of the lane. And the problem is when the steering column is on the left, you naturally position yourself to the left of center with respect to the middle of the lane. And so if you've been driving for years and years like I have in North America or any other country that drives on the right, you have a sense of where you should be. And likewise, a lot of people, when they grow up driving on the left, they also have a sense of where they should be with respect to the lane. And so the problem is I tend to drift too much to the left of the lane. And I got honked at a few times back in March. Haven't been honked at on this road, but there hasn't been anybody to really honk at me on this road yet, but it gets a little less awkward as you get more and more experience. The other problem is that this road, the speed limit is 130 kilometers an hour, which is really nice. You can make great time, but then again, it's only a two-lane road, and for American folk, that's about 80 miles an hour that you're driving, and the other guy is driving, and you get these semis with three or four cars attached. They call them road trains, and these things are just blasting past you at like 70, 80 miles an hour. Well, you could just see that car and imagine, you know, head-on collisions here would not be very good. And I'm out in the middle of nowhere. I don't know if you can make that out, but absolutely no mobile coverage to speak of out here. So I thought that this major highway would at least have mobile coverage, kind of like on the interstates or some of the major highways, even in the sticks out in the U.S., but nope, there's nothing. And I was reading online that, okay, you lose mobile coverage a couple of minutes outside of Alice Springs, and you don't really get it until you get to Earl Dunda, and that's the next stop, and that's about 150K down the road. Have to get there soon. It's about 6 p.m. local time here in the Northern Territory, and I called them last night, and the gas station there is open until 9:30. And so you really want to fill up with fuel when you can, and just stay alert and drive safe out here, because it certainly you know, is dangerous, not only with the speeds but also the wildlife. You have a lot of you know, you're in the middle of the desert here, the Australian outback, but that's fun and should provide for an exciting drive. I'll check in a little bit later. So I'm about an hour outside of Earl Dunda, heading southbound on the Stuart's Highway, going right at the speed limit here of 130 kilometers per hour. Pretty much got the road to myself. I passed a few road trains a couple minutes ago. I don't know if the lens or whatever is all fuzzy, but hopefully you guys can get a sense of what the road is like here. I can't adjust the camera. It's fixed at the moment. So, yeah, I got about an hour to go. I have the road to myself, making great time. I'm fully stocked up on food and water and fuel. And, of course, I'll restock when I get to Rolanda. And then got about 2 hours after I make my stop to get to Ayers Rock. And hopefully I can get there not too late into the evening. I've got about 40 kilometers to go to get to the Rolanda Roadhouse. As you can see, there is absolutely nobody out here. I've seen a lot of little mice scurrying across the road, but not too much in the way of two-legged creatures, and not too much in the way of cars, or trucks for that matter. There's absolutely nobody out here. There's a very beautiful full moon that is to my left. I can't position the camera right now, but I will stop and try to get a video of that when I get gas here in about a little under half an hour, maybe about 20 to 25 minutes from now. So yeah, it's going pretty well as far as the drive is concerned. Don't want to jinx myself by saying, oh yeah, I haven't had any problems now and have the car break down here in the middle of the Australian outback. That would definitely not be good. Pitch black out here, no mobile coverage, and no civilization to speak of. And I really wouldn't want to be walking 20 miles to the nearest service plaza to summon for help if the car broke down. So, yeah, kind of wishing I had invested in a satellite phone for this trip, but I didn't consider the fact. I thought that there would be mobile coverage because this is the main north-south road from Darwin all the way down to the south coast of the Australian continent. So I thought that there would in fact be mobile coverage when there isn't. I should be stepping back in a range of a cell tower within about 10 minutes or so. I read online that there are a few towers around Rolanda, and I'm approaching the limit of what my cell phone would be able to reach in a couple of minutes here. So not too far away from civilization, but still don't want to risk it. Got a rest area here. If I see the cameras wobbling back and forth, and then I've seen plenty of people parked with trailers and such. So I've been told that people driving out here are pretty friendly. They'll lend assistance to a motorist in need if that's required. I don't need any assistance out here. The gas station's open until 9:30. I'll be there. If you can make out the sign, I don't know if the camera focused quickly enough, but 32 kilometers to the Rolanda Roadhouse.
Hi there. I've made a pit stop here at the Rolanda Shell Station. Topped off the car with fuel. There are mice and bugs everywhere. There were even mice running around inside the convenience store. It didn't make me feel too confident about the selection of the foodstuffs that they had there. So hopefully I don't get sick eating the Kit Kat bar that I just purchased, but we'll see. Anyway, about 2 hours left in the journey, and so hopefully everything goes smoothly.